Hello everyone, good day and welcome to your EVS 2 class. Hope all of you are doing well. In our last videos, we completed what is history, history and the concept of time, life on earth and evolution. In this video, we will do a new chapter, a very important chapter, evolution of mankind. Okay, let us start with the lesson. In this lesson, we have to complete the following subtopics. 5.1, from Homo habilis to Homo sapiens sapiens. 5.2, Homo sapiens sapiens to civilization. These are the two subtopics we have to complete in chapter number 5. 5.1, from Homo habilis to Homo sapiens sapiens, and 5.2, Homo sapiens sapiens to civilization. In the previous lesson, we learned that the primitive man evolved from apes. In the previous lesson, we learned that the primitive man evolved from apes. Okay, from apes, the primitive man evolved. That we studied in the previous chapter. The next step for human was learning to use their hands effectively to make tools. Okay, to make tools, the hands were used very effectively. The next step for humans was learning to use their hands effectively to make tools. Okay, from the first step, from primitive man evolved from apes, and the next step, they started using their hands effectively to make tools. Let us start with 5.1. From Homo habilis to Homo sapiens sapiens. The species of humans who could use their hands skillfully is known as the skilled man. Okay, the species of humans who could use their hands effectively, skillfully, okay, is known as skilled man. The first evidence of this species was found in the border region between Tanzania and Kenya. Okay, the primitive man, the skilled man, first evidence of this species was found in the border region between Tanzania and Kenya. In the African continent, Tanzania and Kenya, these are the two places, the border region of this place, the first species of the skilled man was located. In the world map, you can see the area where the first man, the skilled man's species were found. Okay, this are the region. The scientist Louis Leakey, who discovered the species, named it Homo habilis because besides their fossil remains, he found some tools made by them. The scientist Louis Leakey, who discovered this species, named it Homo habilis because besides the fossil remains, he found some tools made by them. In Latin, Homo means man and habilis means the one who uses his hands skillfully. Okay, in Latin, Homo means man and habilis means the one who uses his hands skillfully. Homo habilis could stand on 2 feet and walk. Okay, the Homo habilis man looked like that. Like this picture, the Homo habilis man looked, and he could stand erect, stand straight and walk on. The spine of the Homo habilis is slightly bent and not quite erect. Okay, it was slightly bent, not straight. Okay, not quite straight. Erect means not quite straight. His brain is bigger than that of the apes. The brain of this Homo habilis, okay, is bigger than that of the apes. Although his face and limbs were somewhat similar to theirs. So the face and the limbs of this man were somewhat like the apes. Okay, but their brain was bigger than the apes. Okay, they could stand on their two foot and walk. Their spine was not straight, it was little bent, and they could not stand exactly straight. Okay, this is given here. A reconstructed picture of Homo habilis man. And this is some choppers made by Homo habilis. So these are the tools made by this man. The stone tools made by Homo habilis were not useful for hunting big animals. Okay, they made some tools, and these tools were not useful for hunting big animals. The stone tools made by Homo habilis were not useful for hunting big animals. The tools had limited uses, such as scraping meat from the skin of dead animals or breaking bones to get marrow. These were the two main uses of the tools of the Homo habilis. What are the uses? Limited uses, such as scraping meat from the skin of dead animals or breaking bones to get marrow from the bones. We can infer from this that Homo habilis was a forager. Means he ate the leftovers of animals that had been hunted by other animals. Okay, the Homo habilis ate the leftovers of animals that had been hunted by other animals. It is possible that he hunted small animals and gathered eggs, wild fruits, and roots to eat. Okay, there's a possibility that the Homo habilis hunted small animals and gathered eggs, wild fruits, and roots to eat. Okay, that is 5.1, and in this video we'll only do 5.1, and here are a few questions for you. You have to revise it again, read your textbook, and answer these questions. Fill in the blanks. Question number one, first one. The primitive man evolved from dash. You have to read the textbook again, the lesson again, chapter again, and then find answer, or watch this video again and then try to find answer for this. Second, Dash was a scientist who discovered the skilled man species. Dash was the scientist who discovered the skilled man species. Question 3. In Latin, homo means dash. Fourth one. Dash means the one who uses his hands skillfully. Dash means the one who uses his hands skillfully. 5. Dash could stand on 2 feet and walk. 6. The brain of the Homo habilis was bigger than Dash. Okay, those are the fill in the blanks questions. And now answer the following questions. Question number one. Which species of human is known as the skilled man? Which species of human is known as the skilled man? Question two. Where was the first evidence of skilled man found? In which area? You write in which area. Where was the first evidence of the skilled man found? Question 3. Why did the scientist Louis Leakey named it Homo habilis? okay, why did the scientist Louis Leakey named it Homo habilis? Question 4. What were the uses of the stone tools made by Homo habilis? Question 5. What is the possibility of food collection activity by the Homo habilis? These are the 5 questions you have to find, answer and write. You have to search for the answer in this video again. Watch the video again and search and get answer for all these questions. Okay, and you can even read your textbook. Okay, let us go to the answers. Fill in the blanks. First one, the primitive man evolved from apes. Okay, this is the answer, apes. Second, Louis Leakey was the scientist who discovered the skilled man species. Answer is Louis Leakey. Three, in Latin, homo means dash, man. This answer is man. Fourth, habilis means the one who uses his hands skillfully. So here the answer is habilis. Third one answer is man, and fourth one is habilis. And the fifth one, the answer is Homo habilis. Dash could stand on 2 feet and walk. Answer is Homo habilis. Homo habilis could stand on 2 feet and walk. Sixth one, the brain of the Homo habilis was bigger than the dash, the apes. Answer is apes. Answer the following questions. Question number 1. Which species of humans is known as the skilled man? Answer, the species of humans who could use their hands skillfully is known as the skilled man. Okay, the skilled man. So the answer you must write, the species of humans who could use their hands skillfully is known as the skilled man. Question number 2. Where was the first evidence of skilled man found? Answer, the first evidence of the skilled man was found in the border region between Tanzania and Kenya. Okay, these 2 places you have to remember and write. The border region between Tanzania and Kenya. Question number 3. Why did the scientist Louis Leakey name it Homo habilis? Answer, the scientist Louis Leakey named it Homo habilis because besides their fossil remains, he found some tools made by them. Question number 4. What were the uses of the stone tools made by Homo habilis? Answer, the tools had limited uses such as scraping meat from the skin of dead animals or breaking bones to get marrow. Once again the answer, the tools had limited uses such as scraping meat from the skin of dead animals or breaking bones to get marrow. Question number 5. What is the possibility of food collection activity by the Homo habilis? What is the possibility of food collection activity by the Homo habilis? Answer, it is possible that the Homo habilis hunted small animals and gathered eggs, wild fruits and roots to eat. Your answer, it is possible that the Homo habilis hunted small animals and gathered eggs, wild fruits and roots to eat. This is a complete answer. You have to write. Okay, that's end of all the extra questions and the answers. And it's the end of the lesson part 1. Now for more videos, visit YouTube channel AK Saranatharikil. Okay, visit the channel AK Saranatharikil and go to the videos, and you can watch more videos there. All the videos of your previous lessons you can see there, and it will help for your revision. Okay, whenever you are free, you can visit the channel and watch the videos. Okay, soon we'll be back with the second part of the lesson. Till then, take care.